Good evening, Freeholder Chairman, and to the Freeholder Board, and to the other personnel working for the county and the public. My name is Jamel Holly, Council President of the Borough of Roselle. I come here this evening to urge for your support. One of the beauties that I have of representing a great community as Roselle is represent many different people from many different cultures, Black, white, Hispanic, Haitian. And most recently, I came upon an article in the Westfield Leader that in all my years of reading since the third or fourth grade, this article, in terms of its commentary, was the most distasteful, disrespectful article I have ever read in my entire life. I come to you tonight for your support. Over the last 24 hours since I have read this article, keeping up with the news around the county, and I find it fitting to be here this evening because I've never had to come to a forum of this magnitude to reach out countywide, and I find that this is the perfect forum for this. I have a letter here I want to read to you, then I'll make general statements. Dear 2010 Republican candidates for Union County Countywide Office, one of Union County's greatest strengths is the incredible diversity we enjoy within our communities. That is why we are writing to express our sincere shock and utter astonishment at your comments after the general election held on November 2nd of this year. We are specifically referring to an article printed on November 4th, 2010 in the Westfield Leader in which Freeholder candidate Elise McVed said, "These people, Democratic voters in urban parts of the county, are getting what they vote for. And it's a shame because they won't open their eyes, but we will eventually force them to open their eyes. It's not over." Freeholder candidate Ellen Dixon continued by saying, "Those who are benefiting from the largest are getting a bigger and bigger percentage, and that percentage is sucking all the rest of us." Freeholder candidate Brian Flanagan said, "We've tried so many ways. We just keep getting holes out here in the western end of the county, and it has to stop." The most dismaying were the comments made by candidate for county clerk Arthur Zabalowski, who referred to the Democratic Party's success, saying, "You hit them, people in urban areas, with a cattle prod, and they'll go under. There's no brain power involved." We find those comments, such as these, linger at the border of racism and are not appropriate viewpoints of candidates for countywide or any elective office. These remarks practice the politics of divisiveness that have no place in society today. The residents of our urban communities are just as pensive and deliberate in their voting decisions as those in urban and suburban neighborhood communities. And to suggest otherwise is both insulting and disrespectful. These calculated choices are exhibited when voters elect individuals fighting for those that best represent their needs. Both at the congressional and state level, Republicans have voted to extend benefits for the wealthiest while cutting programs and services for the vast majority of hardworking residents. House Republicans rejected a measure that would have extended unemployment benefits scheduled to lapse on November 30th. Yet, they continue to support extending the Bush tax cuts to the wealthiest 2% of Americans. At the state level, the governor chose to support tax cuts for millionaires, yet submitted a budget that cut vital services to our children and senior citizens. We thank these urban voters who were also joined by thousands of residents throughout the suburban parts of the county and voted based on the real issues. We believe the voters of Union County knew exactly what they were doing on November 2nd, they voted for those that have their priorities in mind, the right priorities. Your condescending statements are simply unacceptable. We collectively urge you to publicly apologize for these disgraceful remarks, to be more considerate and respectful of the voters in the future. We have created a website. The website is www.apologizenowinunioncounty. This letter is written by 17 community leaders, some of which join me here today, and elected officials. That's just within the last 24 hours. This is not going to start, it has begun tonight. The remarks that those candidates made, as I said to you, are disrespectful and they are distasteful. And you, as our county officials, I'm asking you and urging you to join us in this fight. Because it's one thing to lose an election and to be champs about it, but it's another to lose an election and be sour and disrespectful and distasteful. And as an urban voter, this I am appalled by. This I am hurt by. So I come to you tonight to ask you to please join us in this fight for an apology. It's said, it's done, but for an apology so that this never happens again. Field of Chairman, to the Freeholder Board, I thank you for this opportunity, and I will be submitting this letter as I gather additional names for this, but I urge you also to tell your friends to please log on to our website at www.apologizenownuc.com. Thank you.
Anyone else to provide comments at this time?
Good evening, Chairman, and all to the board of residing here. My name is Ms. J. I am a representative of the People's Organization for Progress in the City of Elizabeth. I am vice president there, and I was called upon.
Ma'am, can you just give your town of residence?
Elizabeth, New Jersey.
Thanks.
And I was called upon to speak in reference to this situation. This comment should not be tolerated under any circumstance. If we allow him to say that, then we're gonna allow someone else to come back and say, well, because those people didn't vote, maybe we should have shackled them and chained them and brought them to the voting polls and would have been a better outcome of voters. If that will not be tolerated, his comment should not be tolerated, and those before him or with him, those comments should not be tolerated either. We should not tolerate this Mickey Mouse-minded man's comment to ever be tolerated under any circumstance. This is not the slavery days. We're not trying to turn back the hands of time. We're trying to move forward. We are already going to be mentally whipped by what's going on, and we should refuse to be verbally whipped after all that has come about on November 2nd. So please, we're asking for your support. And I'm trying to be as calm as possible with this situation because there's a lot more I could say, but I'm gonna keep it mild in my manner because I do not tolerate people of his kind. And what I mean by people of his kind, I'm allergic to ignorance. And ignorance should not be tolerated on any level.
Thank you for your comment.
Hi, good evening, Chairman and Board. Cynthia Johnson, Roselle, New Jersey. I'm a business owner, and again, I was very, very disturbing when I read the paper in reference to a remark that was made of cattles. I need them to define a cattle, okay? We having not having brain power, obviously we had enough brain power to overthrow them and win our election. I'm a Democrat. I'm proud to be a Democrat in Union County. I will not allow anyone to demean my character or any other character in the urban community. I am demanding an apology as we speak in reference to comments that was made. Thank you very much.
Thank you for your comment.
Good evening to the Freehold Chairman and to the Freehold Board. Edward Brewer, council member, Hillside Township. I just want to speak briefly on a few minutes in reference to what we have heard here tonight. I think a lot of times when people print things in the media, they do it to divide, they do it for miscommunications, and they do it to separate the individuals who come out to vote at every election time. It's one thing that we learned in the last election on November 2nd, if you looked around the country, the Union County Democrats in this county were steadfast in what they believed in. The voters were steadfast in what they believed in. And we've seen that at the end of the day that the individual who ran for office are back to their jobs that they had previously.